All right. So, let's see. It should be running. Yeah. Okay. So, hey, Thomas. Something a bit different from last year. Sorry I missed the anniversary, but I'll make it up now. You know, this might be not sure what I'd call fun, but at least a different way to reminisce things. I think you would have liked this game very much. A blend of Half-Life and Silent Hill. What could be better? I'm not looking for a challenge, but I'm no sissy either, so medium it is. That oppressive drone. Now that my volume is up, since last time it sounds even more ominous.
My whole life. For as long as I can remember. I don't know if I like it, or if I'm just used to it. But I do know this. Being
Sounds like
lonely
a Swedish
does
guy, all
things
right?
to you.
That S, dead giveaway.
Feeling shit, bitter and angry all the time just eats away at you.
Sets the appropriate tone, I suppose. Actually reminds me of someone I used to know. So yeah, I've never actually visited Sweden, but I used to have relatives there. Or actually, I think my mom said I was there with them when I was little. I don't remember anything of it though. The scenery looks somewhat familiar. There are kind of similar cities here along the coast. It's not like my own city exactly, but you know, we share some Scandinavian similarities. Maybe this more, stream of consciousness style talking out loud will work better than journaling. One is supposed to step back once a while to look into the past, are they not? I guess that if a cry of help is a cry for, well, help, then a cry of fear would be like yelling into the void where there's no one there to hear you. The gloominess and isolation certainly fits the mood. The excessive use of Dutch angles is pretty charming. Uh-oh. That's me on Monday mornings, all right? Okay, and we're playing. Let's see if I can still remember the controls. It's been a while. Half-Life 2. You never got to play that one. So I played this a bit beforehand, and I thought I'd just go through it alone. Didn't get very far, though. Dan almost ended up like that. Shit. I knew that was coming and it still got me.
Did I get here?
How indeed. Phone credit, huh? So quaint. All right, so let me just gotta check something. Okay, right, everything good. I hope this old mic is still working. It sometimes picks echo for some reason. Takes a bit of getting used to again, but I think I still remember most of the basics. Wow, huh, whoops. Wow, I think I missed that the last time. Didn't think I could just drive out of here, but might as well try. There'd be a whole story to tell about a certain church bell. I could write a whole book about what happened in White's End. Not that anyone would believe any of it. There's something about this city ambiance that feels familiar. I don't know. Maybe it's the narrow streets that remind me of southern cities I used to visit as a kid. Used to be more people, of course. So, let's see. No, the other way around. Nice. Ooh, scary. You know, the thing about horror games like this are that I used to be too scared to play them and to watch horror movies. But when shit happens in real life, as in real shit, the kind of shit most people don't know about, it all seems a bit, well, I'll not say silly, but it certainly takes the edge off. You sit safe at the computer and just can press ESC at any point and just walk away. So, what I mean to say is that shock therapy of life works. You hit the soul with enough volts and it burns out the circuits. Classic flashing light. Always love those. You know, I wonder if Thomas's old saves of Silent Hill are still on PS1. That's a weird thought, booting up the game and playing from where he left. I could ask the same question.
Damn it! No No signal.
These weirdos are a bit like the ones in White's End during that winter. Not that they were quite this violent. Come on now. There we go. You don't say. Classic cryptic serial killer stuff. Maybe I should heal. Now this really brings back some memories. Some good ones, but mostly bad. Very bad.